Charger Lab recently got the iQ13. It is equipped with Qualcomm Snapdragon 8 Elite, a 2K screen, a 6150 mAh battery, 120 watts fast charging, etc. Next, let's take a look at its actual charging performance. It comes with a 120 watts charger set. The length of the cable is about 97 centimeters. It can support a current of 6 amps. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows the charger supports UFCS, VFCP, QC 2.0, PD 3.0, PPS, QC 5, and DCP charging protocols. It has 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 3 amps, 12 volts 3 amps, 15 volts 3 amps, and 20 volts 5 amps, and a set of PPS, which is 5 to 20 volts 5 amps. It can support a set of UFCS, which is 5 to 11 volts 3 amps. Compared with iQ12, the battery capacity of iQ13 has been increased from 5,000 mAh to 6,150 mAh. It adopts a dual-cell design and third-generation silicon-negative electrode technology, and the battery energy density is higher at the same volume. It supports 120 watts fast charging and can be fully charged in as fast as 30 minutes. It is equipped with a 6.82 inch 2K screen, 350 megapixel lenses, supports Wi-Fi 7, 360 degree NFC, ultrasonic fingerprint recognition, and IP68 and IP69 protection. The thickness is about 8.3 millimeters, and the weight is about 216 grams. Next, let's do the charging compatibility test. Charge with the included 120 watts charger set, the power can reach up to over 100 watts. The maximum voltage is about 18 volts, and the maximum current is about 5.6 amps. We have compiled the test results into a bar chart. There are no compatibility issues. Except for the old USB-A charger, the power of the USB-C charger can reach above 90 watts. We also used a variety of third-party chargers during the test. Let's take a look at the results. There is no compatibility issue. Most chargers maintain voltages of 9 volts and 17 volts. It is a rare phone on the market that can support 5 amps PPS fast charging. The charging power of chargers that support high-power PPS can reach 39 to 90 watts. The maximum power can reach 89.76 watts. We use the original 120 watts charger to fully charge the iQ13 and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. At first, the voltage is around 18 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 8 parts. In the first part, the power was around 102 watts for the first 1 minute. Then, the power gradually drops to 78 watts, 61 watts, 53 watts, 49 watts, 46 watts, and 37 watts in turn. At about 8 minutes, the voltage drops to 9 volts. After that, the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 33 minutes to be fully charged. From this chart, it can charge the iQ13 to 50% in 3 minutes and 80% in 23 minutes. It reaches 100% in 33 minutes. We also recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and 30 minutes. After 10 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 40.1 degrees Celsius. At this time, the charging power is about 49 watts. The back is 40.6 degrees Celsius. You can see that the heat on the back is uniform. After 20 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 42.3 degrees Celsius. The back is 41.8 degrees Celsius. After 30 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 38.7 degrees Celsius. The back is 40.3 degrees Celsius. At this time, the charging power is about 25 watts. We also turn it into another curve. The temperature during charging is between 38.7 to 42.3 degrees Celsius. The charging power is around 37 to 61 watts for more than 20 minutes, so the temperature was within a reasonable range. Overall, the battery capacity of iQ13 has been significantly improved. The 6150 mAh battery is equipped with 120 watts wired fast charging. It can be fully charged in 33 minutes, which is basically in line with the official propaganda. Many third-party chargers can charge it at a power close to the original charger. This excellent compatibility performance is very rare. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.